back of your way. We got something that is new, that is true. We got something just for you today.
Let me tell you.
Hey, Riley, nice dress.
Boy, you look different.
Yeah, handsome.
All right. It's no big deal.
Au contraire. A recent survey showed that 8 out of 10 people rank clothes ahead of looks in formulating first impressions.
Yeah?
Hey, Riley, what's up? Is the owner starting a new dress code or something?
Oh, no. He's away on vacation.
So why the monkey suit?
An old acquaintance is coming to visit me.
Whoa! Dress for success.
Who is she, Riley?
Yeah, what's her name?
No. She's a he. His name is Wesley.
When do we get to meet him?
I don't know. He won't be in town long.
Well, have you known him long?
Yeah, we grew up together. You know, he was always trying to outdo me. No matter what I did, he had to try to top it. Anything I got, Wesley had to go out and get something bigger. When I got a puppy, Wesley went out and got a bear cub. Yeah, his parents couldn't keep the cub. Wesley wouldn't stop biting it.
He sounds hopeless.
Yeah. Why would you want to impress a guy like that?
I don't know. I guess it's pride. Old rivalries, I guess they die hard.
Riley, you might impress him a little more if you got your tie out of the malt.
Riley!
You could do.
So it, it looks like you're doing pretty well there, Wesley.
Oh, I couldn't be better, Riles. I've got a chain of restaurants, a great house. I just picked up this little car. I obviously can't complain. Yeah. How about you?
What, me? Oh, I'm doing great. Just great, yeah. I'm cleaning up now.
Do you own this place?
Own this place? What? Yeah. Yeah.
Really? How long have you owned it?
Owned what? Oh, gosh. Couple of years now.
Super! Just super!
Super. It's super.
Very nice operation you've got here, Riles.
Yeah, well, we like it.
Must be fun to run a club like this.
Well, I don't often think of myself as a boss.
Neither does anyone else.
Oh, and you've climbed the ladder of success so quickly.
Yeah, practically overnight.
Yeah. Well, what we got over here, this is our counter. Hi there, Gloria. Can I get you anything? Want another pay raise?
No, but I could use a soda.
Yeah, you know, it looks like that fountain guy's not here today. Yeah. I'm gonna have a talk with that boy.
You can say that again.
Unreliable workers. There's nothing worse.
Well, don't be so hard on the guy, Wesley. I mean, I might be a great success today, but hey, I can remember back when I was a lowly fountain man myself.
What a memory.
You know, Riles, you've sure come a long way from the old days. You weren't much good at anything back then.
Yeah, wait a minute. Yeah, well, what about the time I beat you out for that part in the school play, huh?
Yes, well, you played the baby bear in Goldilocks, and she spilt that whole bowl of porridge all over your head.
It got a big laugh.
Yes, well, how about the time I was voted most likely to succeed?
Yeah, that got a big laugh, too. Yeah, and your acceptance speech took 2 hours long. We voted you least likely to survive.
Yes, well, here we are now, two wild and wealthy guys.
Yeah, it feels great, doesn't it? Yeah. Yeah. No, sir, everything's fine. It's just... Yes, sir. Yeah, okay, goodbye. Wesley, you gotta leave town tonight. I mean, I've gotta leave town tonight. I'm going on vacation. tonight. Gotta close the club now.
Nonsense, Riles. Nobody's going anywhere. What's more, I just called Dial a party and ordered enough food to feed an army. Just a little soiree to celebrate our success. I hope you don't mind. I put it on your tab.
But I can't look. Well, we have to talk.
Now, relax, Riles. I don't want to see you turning into another tense executive.
Yeah, but Wesley, I
can't... Ah, here comes the food now. Look at this. Well, then, I must go home and change. Ta-ta for now. See you at the party.
What's Riley? Is there going to be a party?
Not for me, there isn't. The owner's coming back tonight. That means I got to change back into my work clothes and take care of the fountain. Without Wesley seeing me?
Could be tough.
Could be impossible.
Thank you. Thanks for all your encouragement. It's my fault for starting this masquerade anyway.
Riley, I liked you fine before you started getting all dressed up and acting like a big shot.
Yeah, I think that survey was wrong. Clothes don't really make the man.
What we're trying to say, Riley, is that we like you the way you really are.
Yeah, why would you want to be someone else?
Wesley, we have to talk.
Oh. Well, now, what's on your mind besides hair?
Yeah, for one thing, this bill, I can't pay it.
What do you mean, Riles? You're swimming in cash. You've got a packed house here.
This isn't my place, Wesley.
I don't understand.
I'm not the owner here. I'm just the lousy soda jerk that didn't show up.
What?
I pretended to run this place because I didn't want you to think that you made it and I was a failure. I don't know. We've had this rivalry going for so long. I don't know. I guess my pride got the best of me. I'm sorry. You know, but since you have all the money, you're going to have to pay this bill.
I can't pay the bill either.
Well, wait, what do you mean?
I don't really own that chain of restaurants. I just made it up to impress you. I sling burgers over a grill.
Yeah, but the car.
Borrowed.
Well, the clothes.
Rented, except for the socks. You're a cook. You're a soda jerk.
I guess it would have been better if we were just ourselves all along.
I guess so. Hey, what are you doing? Riley, there's no need to fight.
Fight? No, I'm getting ready to wash some dishes. I advise you do the same, too.
I guess we're just a couple wild and working guys. You gotta be kidding.
I know.